Hey everyone, Skye here and welcome back. Today I'll show you how to make CS2 look absolutely stunning with realistic lighting, better colors and sharper details, all without hurting performance and making your game feel a lot smoother. So without further ado, leave a like, subscribe and let's get straight into it.
This is a robbery! Tell me where you keep your expensive skins or I'll blow his brains out!
John, please, don't!
Well, I mean him! What the? Where are the normal skins?
Guys, the best skins are on Skin.Club.
What are you talking about?
Here, look.
Oh, no way!
The best skins are only on Skin.Club.
First, let's start inside CS2. Head over to Settings, then Video, and here's what I recommend for both clarity and visuals. We're gonna turn the brightness around to 100%. This will be less from other options outside the game, so in the game we will make it 100%. This makes the dark areas more readable. Global shadow quality and model texture detail both on high if your computer and graphics card allows it. This gives better depth perception and realism, and the texture detail sharpens surfaces and weapon textures. For texture filtering mode, we're gonna go with anisotropic 8x. It balances sharpness and the FPS perfectly. If not, you can also use 4x. Shader detail to high and particle detail to low. It will improve lighting and reflections, but the particle detail will keep it to low because it doesn't affect visuals that much. Then you have the boost player contrast. Make sure you have this enabled so you can make the enemies stand out. We have the anti-aliasing to TAA or medium, which will smooth edges without too much blur. And then we have finally NVIDIA reflex. You're gonna turn it to on plus boost because it will reduce the input latency. So this is an extra option. It has nothing to do with aesthetics, but it will help you a lot. And then we have optional for aesthetics. We have ambient occlusion, which you can turn to medium or high if your GPU allows it. Next up, you're gonna open your console with the tilde key and try these commands. They enhance brightness, visibility and color balance. So we're gonna start with the most important one, which is R_FullScreenGamma 2.7. This increases the brightness beyond the in-game limits, and 2.7 is a sweet spot. You can go higher if need. This will make it so the colors pop, so we have more contrast. We're not gonna turn this too much. Try anywhere between 2.2 and 2.7 because we will also have to do changes in our NVIDIA control panel, which will affect the contrast and the gamma. So full screen gamma anywhere from 2.2 to 2.7. Then we have the R_DrawTracers_FirstPerson to 1. This keeps the tracer visuals for realism, and you can disable it by setting it to 0 in case it's distracting for you. And the last thing, we have R_showBuildInfoFalse. This cleans the top corner UI or the bottom corner UI for cleaner screenshots or visuals in general. You have no reason to let the build info be there. You're not doing any debug work or things like that. And as a bonus, let's say, you can also use Matte_FullBright to 0 or 1. This is preference, and I'm not sure how it will affect the other options we do this video, so it's your choice if you want to use it or not. Now, let's get to the most interesting stuff of today's video. Let's jump into the NVIDIA control panel. So right-click your desktop, go to NVIDIA control panel, and then go to adjust desktop color settings. Scroll to the bottom and enable use NVIDIA settings. So now, here you go. Adjust these values. In my opinion, they look the best. You can play with them a little bit. I'll give you what I use. So digital vibrance. We're gonna set this from anywhere from 70 to 75%. This adds life to your colors. It makes reds, blues and greens pop without looking too cartoonish. Then we have contrast, which will be around 55 to 60%. This will slightly boost the shadows and the highlights. Then we have the gamma, which we're gonna set to 1.05, which pretty much balances the brightness you added earlier with more depth. And then the brightness from the panel, you're gonna keep it around 50%. If you want to turn it up or down from here, it's your choice. You can also mingle with it in game. Now let's go to manage 3D settings, to program settings, and to Counter-Strike 2. If you don't have it there, you can add it. So for the best clarity and the smooth visuals, I will recommend the following settings. Anisotropic filtering, same as in game. If you went with 8x, go with 8x again. If not, go with what you went. Then you have the low latency mode. Make sure it's put on. plus boost. You have the texture filtering quality, which you're gonna set to high performance. This will help with FPS. Then we have the image sharpening, which will be 0.5 sharpening and 0.17 film grain, which is optional but looks cleaner on stream if you are recording or streaming. So that's your choice. Then we're gonna have an interesting stuff. We're gonna have vertical sync. If you want the most FPS possible, you're gonna have vertical sync set to off. If you want to match the FPS with your refresh rate on your monitor, and if your graphics card is capable of doing that, then you might find it smoother but with an increased delay if you use vertical sync on. You want the most FPS, keep it to off, but you can try both and you can pick. And then finally we have power management, which obviously you're gonna choose prefer maximum performance because we want maximum performance for our game. So apply this and you'll instantly notice sharper edges, vibrant colors and better depth. Now the last thing I want to talk about is a few monitor settings, because your monitor also plays a huge part in how CS2 looks. So you can go into your monitor's OCD or on-screen display menu and tweak these. Now they won't be the same for every monitor, of course, so I'm just saying some general stuff. First of all, it should have a profile or a color mode, and there you can pick gamer or FPS, which comes for first person shooter. It might have a good already made preset for you. You can choose the sharpness from color settings, anywhere from 60 to 70 should be just fine. Contrast around 65 to 75 again, depending on the panel. If you have, you can have a thing called black equalizer, which you can set it to +5 if available, and it will improve the visibility in very dark areas. And then you have color temperature, which you can do warm or normal for less blue light strain. Now if you want to do it warm, you will probably have to decrease the contrast and the gamma in game, because it will feel too much, so be careful. If you're on a high refresh monitor, make sure it's running at 240 Hz or your max rate in Windows display settings. This is also very important. Usually people don't forget about this stuff, but make sure you are always running at the highest hertz your monitor can run. If your graphics card can do more, why not put it to work? So that's kind of it. Your CS2 will now look unreal without losing too much performance, or you shouldn't lose at all performance. You've got bright maps, clear visibility, vibrant color tones that make every map feel alive. So if this helped, hit a like, subscribe, and join the Discord for more CS2 tweaks, settings, updates, all kinds of stuff. It would help me a lot if you would. Thank you a lot for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.